Okay, so this is our first installment of the violin video blog series. And so let's talk about a few things. First is really, what's really important is to be extremely diligent in how you position your hands and just really watching how you do it so that you don't hurt yourself over time, because you can get into some bad habits that will end up, you know, making you have tendonitis in your elbow, or I think I have a pinched nerve in my shoulder just from playing wrong for the first 5 years, and so I don't want anyone to hurt themselves doing this. And so the key to violin playing is to be totally relaxed. If you're tense, it's just gonna hurt and it's not gonna sound good. You're gonna sound like you're tense because it's almost like a voice. You know, how you feel and how you play translates through the violin, so it's gonna sound like you and not just, you know, not just some instrument. So the first thing is, what I recommend is getting a shoulder rest like this one. This is a Wolf, W-O-L-F, Forte Secundo shoulder rest. And it's really good because it's both sides are adjustable, because everybody's neck from here to here is all a different size. So if you get one that's adjustable, it'll make it really easy, because you don't want to squeeze it between your shoulder and your chin. You want it to just hook under your chin and let it go, and you're not squeezing, you're not hurting your shoulder, because it'll hurt after a while. The second thing that I want to show you is, actually it's the two things that you're going to practice for the next couple weeks, and it's how you actually hold the violin. So you put the violin on your shoulder and you just drop your chin into the chin rest and try really, really concentrate on not squeezing it with your shoulder. You should be relaxed enough to just, like you're just sitting here and you don't really have anything. The next thing is how to hold the bow. This is the hard one. This is the one that took a lot of practice for me to relearn. And so what you want to do is just hold your bow by the wood, and don't touch the hair, because then you get your greasy oil, you know, oils from your hands on it, and then it won't play well. But the biggest thing is, when you look right here, there's like this little tiny ledge, and what you want to do is see your thumbnail right there. You want to put it right next to your thumbnail, like your thumb is just sitting on that ledge right there. And that's one of the hardest things to do, and to keep your thumb bent, because if you stick it in and you do your thumb like that, you're going to be tense and you're not going to be able to do the bow right, and it's not going to sound right. So you got to have it on that little tiny ledge, and then you take your two middle fingers, that first joint right here goes across from that little part of your thumb. Okay, so rewind this and just watch it over and over and over again. But this little tiny part right there goes across from that first knuckle on your bow. So if you put your thumb on that ledge, you put your two knuckles right there across from it. Can you see that right there? Right across from those two knuckles. And then your second knuckle of your index finger is what goes up here. And you have that space in between your index finger and your middle finger, and it just kind of rests right there. You don't wrap your finger underneath, you just lay it right there, because the key, remember, is to be relaxed. And then you put your pinky on the top of that wood, because that's your leverage. If you took your pinky off, you drop your bow that way. So that's your leverage on this side, is your pinky. And remember, nothing is straight and nothing is white knuckles. Do you know what white knuckles is? Like when you squeeze something really hard? We don't do that. You'll be totally relaxed. That's why you're still holding it with the wood up here. So this should be, your hand should be so relaxed that you can almost drop it out of your hand. That's how relaxed you have to be. And then a good way to practice that is to put a pencil in your hand and do it just like that. So like you just grab a pencil and you do your the two knuckles across from that thumb, index finger, the second knuckle, and your pinky on the top. And I would just sit there in class with a pencil in my hand like that and just really relaxed. That relaxed to where it just feels like it could fall out at any second. And if you've seen me in concert, sometimes I actually do drop it because I'm too relaxed. All right, so that's what you want to be like. So your knuckles bent and everything is very relaxed. And that's the thing you're going to practice for the next few weeks.